What's going on, guys? It's OG Dugan. Welcome back to another video. Today, right now, I got a news update. This time, it is actually going to be on Naruto. Now, some of you guys may think this is amazing news. Some of you guys may get kind of salty at this news. Bandai Namco Entertainment Japan has trademarked the names for two Naruto games. One sounding kind of meh, and one sounding like it could potentially be freaking awesome, like, or it could just really go either way. First, we have Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm Trilogy, the name that they trademarked, which really doesn't sound like another Naruto game. It doesn't sound like a new game. It really just sounds like a Storm HD collection
that I totally fucking asked for.
For PS4 and Xbox One, but I'm not sure how that would really do. Do you guys think that a Storm collection is actually necessary? I know Storm 4 gets a lot of flack, but I know it still has a community following it. So do you guys really feel like going back to play the old Storm games but remastered? Because I know, like, the old ones, I'm not exactly sure how they hold up compared to how Generations improved the Storm series, in my personal opinion. But let me know what you think about that. I think that news, like, it really surprised me, because I was actually definitely considering talking about the future of Naruto games and where they can really go for here, because they played up Storm 4 like it was really going to be the last Storm game, and I do believe it is, because like I said, this article definitely sounds like this is an HD Storm collection. So let me know what you guys think about that. Not gonna lie, going back and playing Storm 2 sounds a lot like eating cold fucking french fries. But the huge news for this video, this, I feel like it could be amazing. I feel like it could turn out to some shitty handheld game. But this is Road to Boruto, a video game. Now that does kind of sound like it could be a handheld title, and I really hope it's not. We need anime licensed console games to come. Dragon Ball has just come out of what a lot of people were calling a dark age with Xenoverse, where for about the span of 5 years, we didn't really get a good, solid Dragon Ball Z game. And the last two Storm games have gotten a lot of flack. So I feel like this is the Naruto franchise chance to reinvent themselves for games, because it'd be so stupid for just Naruto to only stick with mobile games for right now, considering Dragon Ball, after it ended, it kept producing games, figures, all type of merchandise for a very long time until it finally got a new series. And of course, we still have like the Boruto manga. I mean, if you even read that right now, it's just been a rehash, but there is still like Naruto franchise content going on. So I'd like to see games, if anything. Are they gonna get CyberConnect to develop Road to Boruto? I feel like most likely. Who else could they really get to do it? They've had a lot of success, whether you're crazy about the Storm franchise still or not. CyberConnect has had a lot of success with this series. For a long time, the Naruto games were considered better than the Dragon Ball games. So it just makes the most sense for CyberConnect to be developing this Road to Boruto title. But what they're gonna have to do, they can still focus on PvP, because that's just, I mean, that's what everyone loves to do, you know? You have to have that online connection. I mean, and I doubt they're going to do any type of massively open RPG, so it's still probably going to be like a PvP experience. And it really comes down to, they have to do something new. They have to reinvent their franchise like Dragon Ball did for their video games, and how Namco Bandai really like pulled it together and started using that license wisely with Xenoverse. For having Demps take on a project as ambitious as Xenoverse, really awesome. I want to see what the developers for this Road to Boruto game will actually do to move it to the next level, because I've also been wanting to talk about Xenoverse has raised the bar for anime games at this point, especially with Xenoverse 2 coming behind that first one and just polishing up the experience, adding so much more. I think everybody at this point wants to create a shinobi, have them start off as a genin, or just level up, you know, alongside the new generation of characters whose story is still being told. I think that's what a lot of us want to do right now in like a Naruto game or whatever, just have something besides Storm. I mean, the Storm collection is really cool. It definitely needs online if it wants to even do, if it doesn't have online, I'm probably not gonna buy it, even though I don't even really like play Storm competitively at all. But yeah, like I said, I just hope Road to Boruto isn't like a bad handheld game. If it's a handheld game and it's good, you know, that's one thing and that's awesome, because I love my 2DS. I have tons of reasons to play my 2DS. I love more anime licensed game on the 2DS. That's not fucking like extreme Butoed in this new great Pirate Coliseum One Piece game. That just, these 3DS 2D fighters aren't really interesting to me. Like, I like to play my fighters on console, because 3DS online just, it's not all that.
It means it fucking sucks.
But I think Namco Bandai would be legitimately retarded to not come up with a new generation Naruto game. Because you know people are going to keep buying Naruto games. We just don't know if they're going to keep buying Storm games. I can't speak for everyone. This just seems like the general consensus. So yeah, we don't really have any information on these two titles. We just know Namco Bandai has trademarked two new games. They just came out with the mobile game, so I don't think they're gonna do another one. One of them uses the Ultimate Ninja Storm title and uses the word trilogy. So I'm personally assuming that's gonna be an HD collection. And this Road to Boruto title, just hoping it's something good. Because I've been thinking, like, I really don't want anime licensed game to die. Xenoverse 2 is huge, but like Dimps is the only one like truly pulling their weight right now. Spike Chunsoft is doing all right. They've got some ways to go. I don't know like who the fuck they got working up there now, like nowadays, as opposed to like, you know, 8-10 years ago. But that's besides the point. That might be another fucking video, but that's all I got for right now. Put any thoughts you have in the comment section below. I want to thank you very much for watching. It's been really real, and I will talk to you in the next one. Peace. Bye.